Good morning, my fifth class students. Let's come back to our second part video of second chapter called multiplication and division. We did it up to 46 in video 1, that is part 1. We'll continue with the part 2 video from 47th page onwards. You call it as multiplication. It's very simple, you know, multiplication, but certain things you have to consider that I'll tell you in between. This video is especially for Kritik and Vihan of class 5. Only two students are very much regular sending their homeworks to me. Others, they are not doing properly. But anyway, my job is to tell whatever the subject is. Let us start now. This is on page number 47, multiplication. I'll tell you one so that you can do the next one by yourself. It's very easy. 3059 into 53. First, these two you call it as multiplicands. Okay, we'll start from ones place value digit. We are going to multiply to that number, complete number. 3 nines are 27, 7 2 carry. 5 threes are 15 plus 2, 17. 1 3 zeros are 0, 1 3 threes are 9. Now, ones place value you have multiplied to the whole number. Now you are going to multiply to the whole number by tens place value, that is 5. So leave the ones place value and then start adding the values whatever you get from the multiplication of tens place value. That's why tens place value, we should start from tens place. Ones place value will start from ones place. If it is 3 digit number, if it is from 100 numbers, then you have to start from 100th place. Remember this always. So the first one I'll keep it as this symbol. 5 nines are 45, 4, 5 fives are 25, plus 4, 29, 2, 5 zeros are 0, 2, 5 threes are 15, 7, 12, 11, 12, 6 and 1, 7, 7 plus 5 is 12, 10 plus 1 is 11, 10 plus 2 is 12, 5 plus 1 is 6 and this is 1. This is your answer. In this way you are going to do it. You people were doing since third class. Hope you people are very much in comfort until unless you know the tables up to 9 at least. Let's go to the next one now. Next one you do by yourself. Page number 47 over. We'll go with the 3 digits values here. You are going to multiply to a 4 digit number by 3 digit number. This is 3 by 3, that is 3 digit into 3. I'll leave it. We'll do to this one. We'll do this one. 6227. 6227 into 483. We'll multiply now. You are going to have three steps here. One step is with ones value, then leave the ones value. Second step starts from the tens value when you multiply with the tens value digit in the multiplicand. Let's see. 3 sevens are 21, 2. 3 twos are 6, 7, 8. 3 twos are 6. 3 sixes are 18. Now ones place value is over, so keep one place value vacant. Start now tens place value and write down here from tens place value. 8 sevens are 56, 5. 8 twos are 16 plus 5, 21, 2. 8 twos are 16, 17, 18, 1. 8, 6 are 48 plus 1 is your 49. Your tens place value is also finished. Now we'll go with the 100th place value. So leave 1's place and 10's place. Start writing from 100th place value. 4 7s are 28. 2 4 2s are 8. 9 10. 1. 4 2s are 8 plus 1 9. 4 6s are 24. 1 8 6 14. 1 16 1 17 1 20 2 10 1 3. This is your answer. See here, 1 8 plus 6 14 carry 1, 8 9 10 16, 1 8 8 16 plus 1 17, this is 10, this is 10 20, 4 4 8 plus 2 is 10, this one 2 plus 1 is 3. This is your answer. Let's go to the next problem. There are 3,860 building blocks in a box. How many building blocks are there in 69 such boxes? In one box, you have 3,860 blocks. How many such kind of blocks you have in 69 boxes rather? Just multiply it. In one box, this much. 69 box means 69 into. Okay. So we'll just do it here. 3,860, 3,860. Into 69. 9 0s are 0, 9 6s are 54, 9 8s are 72, 72 plus 5 is 77, 9 3s are 27, 27 plus 7 is how much 34. Okay, plus 6 0s are 0, 6 6s are 36, 8 6 are 48, 48 49 50 51 5, 6 3 is 18, 23. So it has come like this: 0 4 13 4 5 6, 3 3 6, and this is 2. That is 2,66,340 is your what you call building blocks present in total 69 boxes. So you write down the same thing here: 2,66,340. Let me check once again. 9 0s are 0, 9 6s are 54 5, 9 8s are 72, 72 plus 5 is 77, 9 3s are 27, 27 7 34, 6 0s are 0, 6 6s are 36, 8 6s are 48, 49 50 51 5, 6 3s are 18, 19 20 21 22 23, 0 4 6 6 12 13, 1 4 5 6 6 and 2. Yes, let us read this question. This is also as similar as the earlier one. A company sold 5,482 ferry tickets at 124 rupees for each ticket. How much company did collect altogether? We have to find each ticket cost is 124. So 5,482 tickets were sold. It means you have to multiply 5,482 into 124. You do it that and then write down here. That is 5,482. Into rupees 124. Do it and get the answer. Let's go to the next one now. This is practice 4. These problems I hope you people do by yourself, as I told you, as a part of an example. So please do it. This complete section you can do it. It is a good practice if you do all the problems in your classwork. Let's go to the word problems and show your work clearly. We'll try to show our work clearly. Let's see. A worker uses 1077 bricks to build a wall. Each brick cost rupees 13. How much does it cost to build the wall with the bricks? Each brick cost is rupees 13. The total the worker used the bricks are 1077. So what is the total cost? The total cost here, how much does it cost? The question keyword is here, how much? Be careful, right? So we'll start writing and then solution. A worker uses 1077 bricks. Each brick costs rupees 13. So total cost of the bricks, therefore total cost of the bricks is 1077 into 13. Simple. We'll do it here. 1077 into 13, right? If you are good in Vedic maths, you would have done it here directly, but I don't think you are good in that. Try to practice it, and if you pinch me, sir, you do it with Vedic method, definitely I'll do it. You'll get it the answer in just seconds. But anyway, I know out of 18 students, only 2 or 3 sending me the homework. It shows what practice you people are doing at home. Let me go with this. 3 sevens are 21 plus 2 23. 3 zeros are 0, that is 2. 3 ones are 3. 1's place is over. Now go to 10's place value. 1 7 is 7, 7 0 and 1. 1 10 10, this one, that is 14,001 rupee. Let me check once. You should cross check always. Vedic maths, no need to check, because you get very instant value, direct value. But whereas when you do in this way, you have to cross check once again. Okay, 3 7s are 21 2 7 3s are same 21 plus 2 23 2 3 0s are 0 2 3 1s are 3. Then this is same. 10 10 3 plus 1 4 and 1. So the total cost of bricks is how much? Rupees 14,001. This is your answer. In this way you are going to do the working problem. Let us move to the second problem now. A Republic Day float is decorated with 526 balloons. How many balloons are needed to decorate 150 such floats? That's an a Republic Day celebrations. The float actually decorated by a balloons. So each float having 526 balloons. So how many balloons you require to decorate such 150 floats? Let us see. You have to multiply these two, but put it in an order according to the working method. A Republic Day float is decorated with 526 balloon. So one float is decorated with 526 balloons. Now we'll read the next. How many balloons are needed to decorate 520 such floats? So 520 floats need, therefore 150 such floats requires the balloons is 526 into 150. It's very simple. So we are going to now multiply these two. We'll do one thing. I'll give a hint here. 526 into 150. 56 is 30. 52 is 10. 13. 55 is 25. 1 is 26. Then 625. 0987. You keep it zero here, as I told you. Then it becomes 78,900. 78,900. These are the balloons required to decorate 150 floats. So this is your answer. In that way, we are going to do. We'll do the next problem. There are 2,314 almonds in a bag. We know what is almond, right? How many almonds are there in 128 such bags? It is also very simple. The only thing is you have to multiply. In one bag, certain quantity is there. How much quantity you have in certain bags, 128 such bags? It is nothing but we are going to multiply 2,314 by 128. Let us do. Yeah, I have written here, see, there are 2,314 almonds in a bag, therefore 128 such bags contains this. We'll multiply 2314 into 128. You have three things here. We'll cross check once, 2314 and 128. 128. 8 4s are 32. 8 1s are 8. 11. 8 3s are 24 plus 1, 25. 8 2s are 16 plus 2, 18. Plus 2 4s are 8. 2 1s are 2. 2 3s are 6. 2 2s are 4. This is also over. Now 100th place. The same thing, you get it. You have 2,96,192 almonds are present total in 128 such bags. That is your answer. Let us check this once again. 8 4s are 32, 3 8 1s are 8, 9 10 11 1, 8 3 is 24 plus 1, 25, 8 2 is 16 plus 2 is 18, 2 4s are 8, 2 1s are 2, 2 3 is 6, 2 2s are 4. Then 4, 1, this one over, 2, 9, 5 plus 4, 9, 10, 11, 1, 2, 10, 16, 1, 4, 4, 8 plus 1, 9 and 2. This is correct answer. You get it as how much? 2,96,192 almonds are present in 128 bags. Let's go to the next one now. Over. The working problems over here. Let's go to the division. Dividing by 10, we know it. But anyway, I'll tell you. Division by 10, it's very simple. See, there are two methods actually. One method, if zeros are there, you can easily cancel number of digits. Exactly, you cancel to the number of digits present in numerator and denominator. That is one method. And second method is you have to go division method. Our old system, 140 divided by 7 is nothing. We can write it down in this way. 140 divided by 20. This 1010 gets cancelled. 14 by 2, 14 by 2. So 2 ones are 2 sevens. The answer is 7. In that way we can do it. See, answer is 7. We can do in this way. Or second method is this. Directly you go with the division method, that is by 20, you go with 140, right? So how are you going to do? How are you going to do this? See here, 27s are 140, that is 2 7s are 14, this is 0, okay? So you get it 0, so answer is 7. In that way we can do it. You do it the remaining problems. It's very easy. We'll do one example. I'll do this one. 70 divided. You can do this and this. We have three problems here. I'll do one out of three. We'll do it here itself. 70. 625. Just go with the 7 table and check whether you get 62. Where you get 62? You take first two digits and see. 7 tens are 70. Okay. 7 nines are 64. You have 62. 7 eights are 56. So 70 eights are 56 means 560. Simply cancel. 7 nines are 63 means 630 comes. So it is more than 625. So take 8. 7 eights are 56. 0 is there. I kept it 0. 560. Now 5 minus 0 is 5. Here carry. 12 minus 6 is 6. 6 minus 6 is 0. So 65 is your remainder. Quotient is 8. This is your step. Right. Let's go to the next one. Estimation. This is what? Estimation. In division, it is important. Estimation is one of the important topic in divisions. See, 74 by 21. Instead of 21, and always you try to estimate it to the divisor first. Okay, if 74, instead of 74, if it is 94, then you can take the estimation of both dividend and as well as to the even divisor also. But here 74, so let the 74, we can go only with the estimation of divisor. Instead of 21, if you take 20, then it is going to be very easy. Right, you can get the nearest approximate value, that is 74 20. You just leave this zero, we'll go for it. Or else see, 23 is a 60, 24 is a 80. So take 23 is a 60, remainder is 14. So this is quotient, you got it as 3. This is the, your estimation quotient. The estimated quotient is 3. In that way we'll do it. We'll see the next so that you can come back. That is the estimation he has given. But here you please do this very straight now. I'll just explain one. Say example 84. Right? 84 divide to 509. 509, go with 84. Just in 8 table you just try to get the value nearly to 50 and we'll see. Okay, like 8 5 is a 40, 8 6 is a 48, but here it is 4 also. So you think in different way, you have to think in two steps. First is 8, 8 5 is a 40, that is 80 is there, 400, and 4 5 is a 20. Okay, so 400 plus 20 is 420. 8 6 is a 48, means 480, because 8 is in tens place, right? So 8 6 is a 48 means 480. And 4, 6, 24, 24. So it comes almost near to this. Okay, that is nothing but 504 you are getting. In that way you have to think. So 84, 6, we'll take it in this way. 84, 6, I'll multiply here 84 into 6. 6, 4 is 24, 2. 8 6 is 48, 49 50. I told you, we got it the same thing, 504. Directly you can do it, but you should be very smart. According to Vedic concept, you do the best, but practice required. it comes 504 minus how much? 5. This is your remainder, this is your quotient. This way you are going to do the problem. He is not asking to write down in mixed number form or in decimal form and all. Simply he is asking to divide and we did it. Let's go to the next one now. Estimation, as we were discussing, do this problems. Okay, is there anything pending? You do it. He is giving you only divide. He is not asking you to estimate and divide. Okay, so do directly these problems as I told you. Like example, this 21 and 83. If you want, I'll repeat it again so that you can understand much better. I'll do it here. 21, 81, 83. You take first this 2. 2 means 2 is in tens place, so 20. Remember that. So 2 fours are 8. Okay, means 80. 24s are 80. You just first this. And the with 4 you multiply to 1. 4 ones are 4. Plus 4. It comes 84. But you have here 83. So take down 21 threes are simple. 21 threes are 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. If you do it with 4, it exceeds, right? 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. 84 is right exceeded number. Take this. 21 threes are 63. Remains how much? 20. This is your remainder and this is your quotient. So you should write down remainder is equal to 20, quotient is equal to 3. In this way you are going to write down in your notes. Don't leave it as it is. Let's go to the next one now. Right, estimating and adjusting the quotient when dividing a 3-digit number, the same thing. Instead of 33, you estimate it by taking 30 because it is round value. It is very easy to estimate faster. In that way, it is there. Nothing in this you people can do. Even this also, division, please do it. Think it and do it. Given here, do directly, right, actual method and you get the actual value, correct value, accurate value. Don't go with estimation for this kind of problem because he's giving you divide. He's not asking you to do estimate and divide. If in such case you would have estimated this 703 as 700, which is nearest to 700, and 47 you would have estimated to 50, right? In that way you can do it. So divide in that way, 750, you get it as 35. Okay, answer, but don't do it directly. Then dividing with a 4-digit number, everything is giving estimation only, but you don't do it estimation wise. Just go by accurate values. Divide exact this one. You can do even this also. Here I'll explain you. There are three problems. I'll explain this. 64 divided to 6820. Let's see. 64 divided to 6820. Here you have 2 digits, so you take first 2 digits. Okay. If this 2 digits is lesser than the divisor, then you go to 3 digits value. But here you see, you have, I'll do even this also, so that here you see, divisor is bigger than the first 2-digit dividend. We'll see. In this, 64 ones are 64. 68 minus 64 is 4. Now you go to 2. 42. You have taken this 2 here, 42. But 42 is lesser than 64. That is why by keeping 0, you take this 0 again. Remember this. Now see, 64. 6 4s are 24, 6 5s are 30, 6 6s are 36, 6 7s are 42. Okay, that is 420. But here you have 4 more. So you take 64, 6 are 64 into 6. 6 4s are 24, 2. 6 6 are 36, 37, 38. It is 384. 6 384. Just minus it. Carry 10 minus 4 is 6. Here you have a new number is 1. You cannot remove 8. So carry 1 here. It becomes 11. 11 minus 8, 9, 10, 11, 3. So here new number is 3, so 3 minus 3 is 0. So this is your reminder, this is your quotient. If you want to check it, what you are going to do? You are going to multiply these two and add reminder so that you can get this back, dividend. Let's see, let's do it here. We'll multiply these two, 106 into 64. 106 into 64. 4 6 are 24, 2 4 0 0, 2 4 1s are 4, 6 6 are 36, 3 0, 3 6 1s are 6, 4 8 7 6. Plus, reminder how much? 36. You add these two. 0 8 9 10 11 12. 1 8 6 6 8 2 0. You got the same thing. It means what we did is correct. In that way, you want to, if you have time, you can cross check. Let's go to the next one. As I told you, I'll tell you this also, that is, or else we'll do it directly here. Now here you have two digits. Divisor is two digits, but first two digits in the dividend are very less compared to the divisor. So you are going to take three values now, these three values. 149, then you start, right, you check. 149, this is 45, just go with. Take first four in tens place, you start, right, multiplication and keep zero and think. You have to get 149. So 4, 4 1s are 4, 40, 4 2s are 8, 80, 4 3s are 12, 120, 4 4s are 16, 160, it is raising. So 4 3s are, okay, that is 43s are, you can say. So 4 3s are 12, you got 120, same, 5 4s are 20, you got this much, so it comes 140. Easily we can do it. How much? 4, 45, 3s are, you can say. So 45, 3s are. 45 into 3. See now, 5 3s are 15, 1. 4 3s are 12, plus 1, 13. 135, it is nearest. So 45, 3s are 135. Simple. 9 minus 5 is 4, 4 minus 3 is 1. Now you copy this, 145. The same thing, if you see, 135 is closer to 145. Okay, so go once again with 45 threes are 135 comes 10. So this is your reminder, this is your quotient. If you want to check, as I told you, you multiply these two. Whatever answer you get it, you add this. You should get this value, dividend value. Let's check. 45 into 33. 45 into 33. 5 3 is a 15, 1. 3 4 is a 12, plus 1, 13. Same thing. 1495, you got it. So what we did is correct. In that way, you please do it. Let's go to the next one. This is also the same 5-digit numbers given here. Okay, I'll do this. First you started with 2 digits, then you are dividing with 2 digits to a 2 digits number, 3 digits number, then 4 digits. Now we have 6 digits. Do not worry. Just only thing is, if the number is getting shortfall, you just keep 0 in the quotient and take one more value from the dividend. That is the thing you have to remember always. 678 is divided by 58. We'll see. And I'll introduce some Vedic concept in multiplication. Just listen it so that it is very helpful for you. If you learn in that way, it is going to be very helpful to do this kind of big problems faster way. So 58, here you have 2 digits, here you have 2 digits, 61. 61 is bigger than 58, so you can go. 58 ones are 58. It becomes how much? 3. Now you copy this to 32. 32 is lesser than 58. So what are you going to do? By keeping 0 here in quotient, you are going to copy even this other number as 6 there, you copy it. Now 326. You just try to multiply. First you multiply with 5 to the number and check whether you get this 32 or not. Okay. 5, 6 are 30. 50 into 6 is 300. And 8, 6 are 48. 348 comes. It is more than 326. So you take 5 5s are. 5 5s are 25. Means 250. Because 5 is in tens place, so you add 0 to it. 5 5s are 25, 250. 8 5s are 40. 250 plus 40, 290. So 58 5s are 290. If you want, you can check it. 58 into 5. 8 5s are 40, 4 5 5s are 25, plus 4 is 29. 290, you got it. In that way, you have to use your Vedic method. Let's do. 6 minus 0 is 6, 12 minus 9, 10, 11, 12, 3, 36. Now you copy another number is here 7, 367. Earlier we did it, okay, 58 6 is, that is 5 6 is 30, 300, 6 8 is 48, 348, therefore 58 6 is 348. Let us check. 58 into 6. 8 6 are 48, 4. 5 6 are 30, plus 4 is 348. You got it. Now we'll minus it off. 17 minus 8, that is 9. And here you have new number is 5. 5 minus 4 is 1, 19. Now you copy this, that is 198. Now you take 5 table and 50 and all, we can check it. 5 3 is a 15, that is 150, plus 8 3 is a 24, 174. 174, you get it. Let's see, 174, we'll see here. That is 58 3 is a 174. Let us see, 58 3 is a 8 3s are 24, 2, 5 3s are 15, 16, 17, 174, you got it. If you take 4s are, 58 4s are, it crosses 200, which is bigger than 198. So you take it 58 3 times, 58 3 times 174. Now you subtract it here, it becomes 24 as your remainder, and this is your quotient. Let us check this, whether what we did is correct or wrong. Let us check. 10563 into 58. I told you, quotient into divisor, whatever answer you get it, you add remainder to it. That should be equal to the dividend. Let us do. 8 3s are 24. 6 8s are 48, plus 2, 50. 5,
8 5s are 40 plus 5 45, 8 zeros are 0 4, 8 ones are 8. This is your first ones number you have multiplied it. Now you go to the tens. 5 threes are 15, 1. 5 6 are 30 plus 1, 31. 5 5s are 25 plus 3, 26, 27, 28. 2. 5 zeros are 0, 2. 5 ones are 5. Now you are going to add it. Okay, 4, 5, 6, 8 plus 4, 12, 10, 11, 6, this much. Now you add remainder to it. We'll add remainder to it. 8, 7, 6, 2, 1, 6. 6, 1, 2, 6, 7, 8. 6, 1, 2, 6, 7, 8. In that way you are going to do. Hope you people have understood this. To make it fast, you use, introduce multiplication. I have shown you one method. Once if you perfect with double digit into single digit up to 100 or thousands, then we'll go double digit into double digit, Vedic method. At that time, you know, you can do this problem in just 3 to 4 seconds. You get this answer and also you get the remainder in just 3 seconds. That I'll show you later. Come back to the next one now. We'll see solving word problems here. We'll go for it. 486 stickers are shared equally among 23 children. How many stickers does each child receive? How many stickers are left? So, certain example I'll tell you. There are 10 mangoes equally divided into 3 children. Now you have to tell me how many mangoes each children gets and how many mangoes remains. That is nothing but 3, 3, 3. 9 remaining mango is 1. Okay, in the same way you are going to divide 486 stickers by 23 children. Whatever the remainder comes, here given, same thing. 21 is your quotient, that is each child got 23 and remaining stickers are how many? 3. That is what given here in this way. You can do it, you can go through it. Let's do the next one and see. We'll do this. Ravi collected rupees 3672 from the sale of 54 circus tickets. The price of each ticket was the same. What is the price of each ticket? Simple, you have to divide. Okay, that is rupees. After selling 54 tickets, he got 3672 rupees. One hint is given. The ticket cost is same. The value of each ticket is same. It means what? You divide 3672 by 54 so that we can get it. Let's see. So here you got it as 360. First, if you take two digits is smaller than this. So you take three digits and you can do it. 367, right? 5, 6 are 30. 5 sevens are 35. If I take 7 times to 54, what happens? 54 sevens are, means 7 fives are 35. 350, 7 fours are 28. 350 plus 28 is 378, which is more than this. So you take 6, 54 6. Okay. So what happens? 54 6. 6 fives are 30, 300. Then 6 fours are 24. 300 plus 24, 324. So you can easily go for it. So 54 by what? 54 6, right? How much I told you? 300 plus 24, 324 you get it. Minus 324. If you want, you can check it here. 54 into 6. 6 4s are 24, 2, 5 6 are 30, 324, you got it. Minus now, how much it is? 3, this is 4 and this is, you copy this 2 here. 7 minus 4 is 3, 6 minus 2 is 4, you copy 2 there, 432. Now again you check it, 54, now you see, 5, 6 is 30, 5 7 is 32, 5 7 is 35, 5 8 is 40, 54 8 is, 5 8 is 40, 400, 4 8 is 32. 432, you got the same thing. So 54 8s are 432. Let's see, 54 8s are 54 into 8. 8 4s are 32, 3. 5 8s are 40 plus 3, 43. 432, you got it. So what is the price of each ticket? The price of each ticket is 68 rupees. 3672 divided by 54, you get it as rupees 68 each. So the price of each ticket was 68. Don't write this. When Indian rupee symbol comes, you should not write slash and hyphen. Okay, rupees 68. Let's go to the next one. Hope you do this. If not, I'll explain. I'll give the hint so that you can do by yourself. A company has a pack of 10,962 bottles of water into a boxes of shipment. Shipment means to dispatch. Each box can only hold 85 bottles. How many bottles are needed to hold all the bottles of water? Simple, you divide this, right, and do it here. That's all. That is 10,962 divided by how much? 85. Enough. Please try to do it. I'll show you the concepts of Vedic maths for double digit into double digit into triple digit, when you become perfect in single digit to double digit first. Hope you will learn the tables as I mentioned you earlier, or else just go through my other videos, Vedic concept videos. You can revise once from that and then practice it. You people, please do this. Okay, this is very easy, please do it, and then we'll do the word problems. Solve the word problem, show your work clearly. Let us do. Mrs. Mehta divided 6048 equally in 16 envelopes. How much money did each envelope hold? So this amount actually, right, divided into 16 envelopes. We'll see that how much money each envelope has. Okay, let us go. Mrs. Mehta, I'll do it on the other equally. So she kept, right, the amount equally in 16 envelopes. We have to find out how much money is there in each envelope. So each envelope holds how much? That is nothing but 6048 divided by 16. We'll do it here. 16, 60, 48. Right? 16 table, hope you know it. Otherwise, again the same thing. 16 threes are 48. How are you going to do this? First you do this Vedic concept. 3 ones are 3, that is 30. 6 threes are 18. 30 plus 18, 48. In that way you are going to do. Now 60 minus 48, how much? You just carry here 10. 10 minus 8 is 2. 5 minus this one, 12. Now you copy this one. 24 it becomes, then
16. Now you go with say eights example. 1 8 that is 80. Then 6 8 48. 80 plus 48. 128. That is more even. It is 124. We'll go to 16 7. Okay, let's see. 16 into 7. 1 7 70. Then 7 6 42. Right? So how much it come? Yes. So 16 7 112. This way, you know, it really makes me tough because I have a habit of doing directly. 16 7 1 7 70. Okay, 70 plus 7 6 42. 70 plus 42. How much? 112. You got it here. So you take this 128 now. 16 into the same thing, I believe. Okay. 16 8 if you take it. 8 6 48. 8 1 8. 9 10 11 12. 128. So 16 8 128. You got it as rupees 378. So we'll just write it down here. So each envelope holds rupees 378. This is your answer. Let's go to the next problem. Mrs. Gupta has 2145 rupees. What is the maximum number of fountain pens can buy if each pen cost rupees 64? The cost of a pen is 64 and Mr. Gupta has rupees 2145. You can do it. Simply divide this. Okay, we'll do it. Mr. Gupta has 2145 and the cost of each pen is 64. The cost of each pen is rupees how much? I'm unable to get 64. Therefore, he gets the total pens are 2145 divided by 64. You just divide it and we'll see. Okay, we'll go with the division. 642145. Here two digits, here two digits, but these two digits are lesser than 64. So you take 214 and find it out. 64 is 24, 240, it goes 240. 63 is 18, you can take. That is 64 into 3. Okay, 63 is 18, 180, 43 is 12. 180 plus 12, 192. So 64 3 is 192. Let us check here. 64 into 3. 43 is 12, 163 is 18, 192. Okay, right. So minus now 19, 20, 21, that is 2 and this is your 5. Now you can go 6 3 is 18. Okay, you got this one. 6 4 is 24. Again it goes high. Let us see. 64 3 is, if we take it, we'll take it. 64 3 is how much? 192. If you minus it, it becomes how much? This much. 19 3, that is 33. Right? So remainder is 33 and this is 33. Let us check. if we go with this and this, she, I mean, Mr. Gupta, he gets 33 pence and still he left with money rupees 33. Let us check this now. We'll multiply these two. 64 into 33. 64 into 33. 4 3 is a 12, 1. 6 3 is a 18, 19. Same. Okay. 9 10 11 1 9 10 11 1 2001 12 33 5 4 1 2 2 1 4 5. You got this. It means what? It means, I'll rub this anyhow. You rewind and watch, rewind and see this. 64, when you divide it, you get it as quotient is equal to 33 and remainder is equal to 33. You have divided to rupees. You have divided to rupees. So remainder means rupees left. And how many pence Mr. Gupta can buy? Gupta can buy 33 pence and he remains with the money 33 rupees with him at the end. That is what he can, that he gets the total pence are 33. So Mr. Gupta gets 33 pence and leftover money is rupees 33. This is your answer. Still he remains with rupees 33 after buying 33 pence. Let's go to the next one. It's very simple. 10,650 special edition balloons were distributed equally among 38 schools. How many balloons did each school receive? How many balloons were left? Yes. So whatever the remainder is there, that is left, and whatever the quotient you get it, that is the number of, right, the number of balloons each school gets. Let us do it here. 10,650 solution. 10,650 balloons were given equally to 38 schools. 38 schools, 10,650 balloons. Let us see. Therefore, each school gets 10,650 divided by 38. We'll do the division and we'll check it to 10,650. Okay, so you take first 106 because 10 is lesser than 38, two digits, so take it three digits. Now 38, if you take 38 fours are 3, fours are 12, it goes to 120. If you take 38 threes are 3, 3s are 9, 90, then 8 threes are 24, that is 114, which is bigger than 106. So you take it 38 twos are mean 3 2s are 6, 60, 8 2s are 16, 60 plus 16, 76. So 38 2s are 76. So 106 minus 76, how much? 30. It is, now you copy this one, it becomes 305, right? 305. Now, check it now, how much it comes. It goes into 8. Let's see. 38 into 8. 8 threes are 24, 240. Then 8 threes are 24. Oh, sorry. 8 threes are 24, 240. 8 8s are 64. How much? 240 plus 64 is 304.
So 38 8s, I told you, no? Yes, 38 8s are 304. If you want, you can check it. 38 into 8. 8 8 is 64, 6. 8 3 is 24 plus 6, 33. Not 4, you got it. I feel a little difficult in doing these kind of things because I have a practice of doing Vedic concepts. Sorry for that. But this is one here. See, when you are carrying this zero here, okay, when you carry this zero reminder, you keep this zero even here also. Remember that always. Okay, now we'll check it. We will check it that each school get 280. Okay, each school get 280 balloons, still remains with 10 balloons. It means what? 280 schools get 10,640 balloons, remaining 10. If you multiply this and this, you should get 10,640. Let's see that. That is 280 into 38. Okay, just cut down this, we'll see. Write down only 280. Later on, we'll keep it zero in the answer. 8 8 is 64, 6. 8 2 is 16. 16 plus 6, 22. 8 3 is 24, 2. 3 2 is 6, 7 8. 8. I told you the zero. The zero, you keep it here simply. See, 10,640 plus remainder is how much? 10. So total is 10,650. You got this 10,650. In that way, you have to do this problem. We'll do now a little working. How much? 280 balloons. So each school gets 280 balloons. Balloons. And how many balloons left? 10 balloons. This is your answer. In that way you are going to do it. Hope you people have understood. Let us go the same thing, problem solving. Okay, please do this. Do this and finish it off. There is nothing, only approximation and other stuff. These four problems, you do it by yourself, and please, for the God's sake, you show me. Especially Kritik and Vihan. I want these four problems to do. I did all working problems, right? Please do it. After that, you know, chapter ends. By this, we have finished second chapter. Hope you have understood multiplication and division. Now you got complete second chapter, first chapter and third chapter part one, right? I want your notes up to date, and wait for another couple of days to finish your third chapter part two also. Till then, stay happy, stay safe. Thank you.